Easter, birthdays, Christmas, Thanksgiving. Even that Thanksgiving when Carol was dying, I was staying with her in the hospital. We miss you so. Our day is nothing without you. Couldn't you come up for an hour or two after you leave Carol? You had no regard for what was really going on. My wife was dying.
Is it so terrible to want to see your own son?
It's terrible to want to possess him entirely and completely, yes.
There'll be some papers to sign for your mother's estate. Be sure to leave an address with your lawyer.
Oh, Dad.
From tonight on, you can consider me dead. I've given you everything. Since I was a snot-nosed kid, I've worked my fingers to the bone for you. You had everything. I had nothing. I put a roof over your head, clothes on your back,
food on the table.
You ungrateful bastard!
What do you want for gratitude? Nothing. Nothing to be enough for you. You resented every damn thing you ever gave me. The orphan boy and you resented everything. I'm sorry as hell about your miserable childhood. When I was a kid and you used to tell me those stories, I'd come up to my room at night and I'd cry. But there's nothing I can do about it now. And it does not excuse everything. And I am grateful to you. And I admire you and respect you and stand in awe of what you've done with your life. I'll never even be able to touch it. But it does not make me love you, and I wanted to love you. You hated your father, and I saw what that did to you, and I did not want to hate you.
I don't care what you feel about me.
Well, I do. I came so close to loving you tonight. I've never felt so open to you. You don't know what it cost me to ask you to come with me. And I've never even been able to sit in the same room alone with you. You really think your door was always open to me?
It's not my fault if you never came through it.
Goodbye, Dan. I'll arrange to have somebody come and stay with
you. I don't want anyone to come in. I can take care of myself. I've always had to take care of myself. Who needs you? Out! I've lived my whole life so that I can look any man in the eye and tell him to go to hell.
That night, I left my father's house forever. I took the first right and the second left, and this time went as far as California. We saw each other a few times after that. We visited him, and he visited us. But then the arteries began to harden. We put him in a hospital, and he gradually slipped into speechless senility. Not long after, sitting and staring without comprehension at television, he died. Alone. Without even an orange in his hand. Death ends a life. But it does not end a relationship, which struggles on in the survivor's mind towards some resolution which it may never find. Alice said I would not accept the sadness of this world. What did it matter if I never loved him or he never loved me? Perhaps she was right. But still, when I hear the word father, it matters.